In the same manner as I did last September 2019, when I received several media requests concerning the production of the independent film Wasp Network, I will not be giving interviews about the distorted portrayal of my persona in this anti-Cuban exile, socialist, communist-leaning film project, with which I had no involvement or was ever consulted on. This film was based on a poorly written book filled with inaccuracies and fabrications authored by a known Castro sympathizer. The film director enjoyed some accolades from his previous projects, which enabled him to assemble a respectable cast. The production company consulted with the Cuban spies and the Cuban government, but they did not consult with any of the Cuban-Americans or others in Miami who were portrayed in this film. That speaks volumes about the agenda behind this project. The information compiled for the development of the character that attempts to represent me was acquired via bits and pieces of published articles and social media. The rest was fabricated using the tactic of half-truths to make it appear credible. This applies to everyone else depicted on this side of the Florida Straits. The film received dismal reviews, as did the actors, to the degree that it was pulled from festivals and re-edited in an attempt to salvage the storyline. The movie never made it to theatrical release in the United States and was eventually sold to the streaming channel that is currently broadcasting it. I would like to clearly state that I have not watched the film, nor do I intend to. Aside from multiple media interview requests, I have also received countless messages of support from many who know me and are outraged by the portrayal of my character in this movie. For this, I am truly grateful. Every person seeing this film is contributing to the proliferation of the Castro regime's propaganda. I call out to anyone who stands for truth to avoid watching this film and show the streaming service how this type of content is simply a bad investment. A film which is already a failure, having only made $1.4 million worldwide. My comments will be limited to the statement. I respect the obligations of the media to report about what is controversial, but I honestly would love to see this film die a quiet, dusty death as an obscure title in a streaming service and never recoup the $17 million that was spent making it. Thank you.